Okay guys, I just kind of want to share with you my cowboy pasta from Hawk Vittles. This is it, and as you can see, it turned out a little bit soupy. I think the problem was is since I put it in a Ziploc bag, I added water just over the noodles like it said on the instructions, but I think that since the bag is shaped differently, it was actually more water than what I should have added. So you can see it's kind of soupy, but I've got to say, even with it being soupy the way it is, it's pretty dang good. It's like soup. The noodles are tender. It's got good seasoning. And just all around is really good. So I'm really happy with the cowboy pasta from Hawk Vittles. Suggest anybody check it out if they think they might be interested in it. That's all I wanted to share. I'm going to go finish eating this, and then I'm going to get everything ready for bed. See ya. Do what?
Doesn't take long for your boots to cool
everybody, it's me again. We decided we slept in just a little bit since we only have about a 7.5 mile hike today, so we didn't break camp till about 10:15. So now we're headed to Gooch Mountain Shelter for the night. We plan on stopping on top of Sassafras, take us a little lunch break. Right now we just climbed about a high tower gap, and I gotta say, first thing in the morning, it kicked my butt a little bit, but I will say that, man, this pack weight sure is nice, sure is making things a lot easier. I'm really happy with my weight so far. I'm really happy with the way everything's performing so far, actually. I don't think I've had anything that's been disappointing. But anyway, so like I say, we're headed to the top of Sassafras. We're going to have some lunch. Figure we'll get the big hike, or the big uphill done for the day, and then stop and take a break. Sounds like a good plan. But anyway, just hiking along part of the trail here. I want to say a lot of people have noticed my backpack and my tent. And a lot of people says, hey, did you make that? Kind of funny. I tell them I wish I did. But anyway, everything's worked out really good so far. Oh, I want to say that I didn't have a bit of condensation inside my tent this morning. I did sleep with the beak pulled down, but to be fair, we weren't exactly next to a stream or anything. We had a good breeze all night, so to be fair, just kind of put it in perspective a little bit. But I was super happy when I reached up and felt the wall of the tent, and I didn't feel a bit of wetness, so that was sweet. So see how it does again tonight. I don't know what kind of conditions will be, but I'm gonna pitch the tent again tonight at Gooch Gap, or at Gooch Mountain Shelter. So anyway, I'll just show you part of the trail a little bit, and then I'm gonna call it quits. I may do some more filming when we stop for lunch. Hey guys, it's me again. I'm headed down from Justice Mountain almost to Justice Creek, and then from there we just got about 1.3 miles left to our destination for the night. Anyway, while I was on this simple level kind of part, I wanted to talk a little bit about the my wind jacket that I'm wearing. This is the North Face Verto wind jacket. It's a size large, weighs 2.9 ounces. And I want to say, I was real skeptical when I got the wind jacket. My thought was, you know, I'm already carrying a rain shell, so why do I need to waste 2.9 ounces on a wind jacket? But over time, I decided, hey, what the heck, I'll give it a try. And I gotta say, I'm pretty glad I did. I found that with my rain jackets that I have, if I'm hiking along and I'm kind of getting cool and I decide to put my rain jacket on, it doesn't take long for me to start overheating. Of course, my rain jackets, I require pit zips. But even with unzipping those, sometimes it's still easy to overheat. So with my wind jacket, I found that it does great. It obviously breathes well enough so that I can dump some of the heat off just, you know, through the shell, I guess. But I don't know, I'm really happy with it. It does a great job at blocking the wind. Obviously, it's a wind jacket. But it's been a valuable piece to have, I think. I keep it in my front pocket on my pack. So if I decide I need it, all I do is set my pack down, jerk it out, put it on, and pick my pack back up, and I'm gone. At first, I was thinking about keeping it in my multi-pack, but what I realized is I might have to take my pack off if I want to put the jacket on or take it off. So there's no sense in wasting space inside my multi-pack with that when I can just keep it outside my back pocket. So I'm really glad, I'm really happy with the way the wind jacket works so far. Temperatures so far have been low, about 15, high, I don't know, I'd say around 40, something like that. And it's worked in all of it pretty well. There has been a few times climbing Sassafras this morning on towards the top. I ended up taking it off because it was just hot. Sassafras, kind of a butt kicker. So I did take it off at that time, but as soon as I start descending the mountain, especially if I'm on the opposite side of the sun, kind of get a little cool, so I'll just throw it right back on and go. But anyway, just wanted to say a few words about the wind jacket, because I was a bit skeptical about it for a while, but it's proved its point to me. Also, I like to wear it in camp. Last night I'd say it probably got down to mid-teens, I don't know, 15, 16, 17, something like that. And I had my base layer on, then I had my R1, then I put the wind jacket on, and then I put my insulation over that. And as the night went on, I ended up putting my anti-gravity gear seal nylon jacket on, my rain jacket, over all that, and it worked out real well. So anyway, big thumbs up to my wind jacket. Just wanted to share that. I'm gonna put this up. We should be coming up on Justice Creek. And I'll do some more video later. See ya. Okay guys, we're at Gooch Mountain Shelter. We got here a little bit later than we had anticipated today, but we're here, we're set up, we're getting ready for the night, getting our meals cooked and all that good stuff. They have some campsites that are all throughout there. They're on some little pads that have been built. We just found a couple of spots that were close to flat up here near the shelter, that way we could use the tables and everything and the fire pit. Be interesting to use my tent tonight because I'm on a little bit of a hill, so I'll see how well that floating floor does, see if it slides down like it does in my Lunar Duo. So I'm interested to see how that's going to do. Anyway, it's my setup tonight. It's the same as before. Got everything in there, and then this is a shelter. It's got two levels. And should be just about boiling. I'm gonna have sweet Italian sausage for pasta. I'll update you probably tomorrow on how well that does, because it might be too late tonight. But oh, shouldn't be too much longer. Anyway, we come from down there. Bear cables are down there. And here's the shelter. It's a pretty nice shelter. It's just built on a hill. So we've got George's setup, my setup, and Andrew's setup's back there. The previous back around to the right behind the shelter. And there's a water source. It's just a pipe coming out of the ground. Makes it really easy to fill up stuff though. Anyway, just wanted to check in with you a little bit. I'm not going to do too much tonight just because we got a lot of stuff to do and it's getting late already. So I'll holler at you later.